What is going on? We are here with the Ensoniq EPS16 Plus, and today we are going to demo B28 of the Carpenters Sawdust, which is a collection of waveforms specifically designed for the Ensoniq trilogy, that is the EPS Classic, EPS16 Plus, which we have right here, and the ASR-10. If you don't know what it looks like this right here. A floppy disk proprietarily made for these vintage samplers. Now, before we get started, just a bit of news. Very quick. Episode 168 of the Samplers Podcast, live right now at the Daydream Sound website. Blog number 23 of the Daydream Sound blog, live right now. And if you are subscribed to the monthly mailing list, your newsletter has been sent out. Check your email. Now, on to B28. B28 is described as a monophonic gliding fifth interval. That means it's made up of two waveforms, a root and a fifth, fizzy saw-like waveform. Now, we have a couple things going on here. The aftertouch is activated, and if you press, you get a bit of tremolo and vibrato. Also, the mod wheel here, right, that modulates through the waveforms, creating a slight change in timbre. So, now that that's out of the way, let us check what this sound sounds like, all right? Remember, it's a fifth interval, so let's just take a listen. So that was a bit of the aftertouch at the end. So it's just another playing style or playing option that you have when you want to add some stuff. So now let's check out the modulation wheel to see how it changes while we move. All right, here we go. Really nice options there. And of course, we could not demo, not with me anyway, without doing delay. Love delay. I especially coming from the Ensoniq effects algorithm. Absolutely amazing. DP4 stuff, amazing. All right, let's check it out. Absolute beautiful stuff. This is, you know, fifths always do well when you want to really get aggressive and you really want to add some sort of, it's a polarizing interval. You know, you to play the root in the fifth, it's sort of conflict and resolution at the same time. Very, very 90s electronic music or any type of electronic music or suspenseful stuff or prowling stuff. Like a fifth just sounds like someone's coming to get you, you know, type thing, or something is coming to get you. Anyway, that is B28 of the Carpenter Sawdust. If you want to know what all these sounds sound like, well, to be truthful, right now we're on B28. We only have four more to go after this one. So you'll have all, almost the entire collection very soon to listen to here on YouTube to decide if this is for you. But if you want to read through the manual is free and it's at the Daydream Sound website, and you can see everything to deal with the Carpenter Sawdust, as well as the applications of each, the compatibility. It's a manual. It's free. Check it out to see if this sort of item is for you. However, if you own an EPS Classic, EPS 16 Plus, or ASR 10, and you don't have the Carpenter Sawdust as yet, what are you waiting for? Get yourself on to the Daydream Sound General Store and get yourself sorted, of course, as well. If you want to get the fullest from these Trilogy samplers, they're incredibly powerful. They're very closely related. The Ensoniq ASR-10 Beginners Manual at the Daydream Sound website is a companion for this. These two things together help you learn the fundamentals of all these samplers, as well as the power of them through this disc. By just using these sounds and seeing how they're made, teaches you a lot about the synthesis structure of these samplers. They're incredible. There's a reason why we still talk about them today, decades later. It's not by chance. Anyway, that is all I wanted to share with you today. I will catch you on the next one. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.